Greetings everyone, it's time for a video. This one is kind of a sort of an unboxing, but it's random tool comments. This time it's about the Wera 2020 advent calendar. I will go ahead and say right up front that I'm not going to do a full in-depth review of this or go into all the individual pieces. Other people have done an excellent job of this. In fact, specifically I would say that if you want to see someone who's really put in the effort to go through and break down each individual thing, and all that will make sense in a moment when I crack this open, go check out Lone Star Mopars. He had an excellent unboxing video where he went into detail about each individual thing and pulled them out. My purpose in this is really more just to cover some general points as well as some specific things about the set itself. I'm not really going to go into details about the whole thing with advent calendars. Wera, of course, produces these. This is what they have. What I'm going to do is cover this briefly, kind of an overview of this one, and then crack it open, pull out the stuff, and then go through some specifics. So, without further ado, before I forget, I will have a link in the description to Lone Star Mopar's video on this, so you can watch this and go see his if you want to see, you know, specifics. Anyway. So this is the box itself. I will say I picked this up on eBay, actually at a pretty decent price. These did come out earlier this year than normal. Wera always produces these annual calendars, and this one came out a little quicker. KC Tool, of course, put their advertising thing. I debated not getting this, but there's a couple things in here that I decided I wanted to check out. And since part of the purpose that Wera does these is, other than, of course, doing this kind of nifty special, is they also give you the opportunity to go and look at things in their tool line that you may not be able to get, or you may not yet want to jump in and grab completely. So that's part of the reason why they do this. And there were a few things in here that I liked, so I wanted to look at them. They sold out quick. I think KC Tool got another load, and then that was it. And then there are others that still have them. If you hunt around, you can find them. Europe still has some. I think some of the sellers that are in Germany and other places, you can find them on eBay. In fact, that's where I got mine. I'll put a link to the search in the description below where you can search, and hopefully you'll find this. I actually got this cheaper than what it was selling for at retail. I think, and don't quote me on this, it was either $70 or $80, which is roughly about where it's at. But I got this, I think, lower 60s, like 63, and that included shipping. So, pretty good deal. Anyway, here it is. Here's the front. They have all the stuff. This, by the way, is the external box, which the actual calendar ships in. And, in fact, they tell you that right here. Of course, on the back, they have, you know, all their marketing stuff and whatnot. They show you, of course, here is all the different calendars. They started in 2010. So, this is 2020, this will be 10 years, I guess, or, well, 11 years, because we're now on 11. So, pretty cool. I have these two, and now this will be the third one I have. They show you the things, of course, that are in there. So, I'm going to pull this open real quick. I'm not, like I said, I'm not going to dwell on this too much. And what you do is you pull out the other calendar. There you go. It's the same thing, but now you're actually in the calendar. And, of course, they're numbered. Again, I'm not going to go into too much detail about this. Others have done a better job, but I still want to give a brief overview. So, like, for example, the first day, if you're doing this as an advent calendar for Christmas, you would start and you would count down each day. First one, as you would expect, you get the storage pouch, as well as, in this case, the Velcro that Wera always includes. And I'm going to talk about this later on when I get everything out. So, I'm going to pause here. And I'm going to pull everything out, and then I'm going to come back, and then I'm going to go into the specifics about certain things about the set that I wanted to talk about. Anyway, back in a moment. All right, everything's unloaded, all packed up, all removed. The damage has been done. All right, all that ends up becoming, as always, all of this. And that's how these things work. You get a set, a small custom set they put out once a year. Kind of collector's item in a way, but again, this is what they get. So I'm going to grab something real quick and I'll be back in a moment before I go any further. All right, I'm back. So here's the set. You get, of course, a bottle opener. You get the Velcro, which has adhesive on the back. so you can like mount it. The Germ Tool Views guy, he talked about this years ago when he was talking about the Wera to go system. Wera started putting Velcro on their various sets. Like this is this year's obviously, and last year's had Velcro on the back so you can mount it. You know, you can stick this, get your own Velcro, do whatever you want, and you can put them wherever. Of course, you get the little, you know, flyer, etc. Talking about the bottle opener real quick, Lone Star Mopars covered it pretty well, but I will do a short comparison. He did ask the question of whether or not people would rather have a part, like another part of the tool or, you know, something like that versus this. I don't really have an opinion either way. I mean, if some people feel like they were kind of ripped off, then the 2019 set, which I also have, we got two in that one. You got a bottle opener and a corkscrew for, you know, opening wine bottles and whatnot. So speaking of last year's bottle opener, this is it. Just to give you a rough comparison, it's really the same. You know, this is kind of an example of their stubby handle. Not really any major difference other than, of course, you can tell you've got blue versus green. I did notice that the chrome on the older one was a little more satin, while on this newer one for this year's set was a little, kind of a little brighter. And then, of course, as you noted, you got the Tool Rebel thing. Also, if AutobahnDan had ever picked this up, it could go in his massive collection of bottle openers, which, by the way, I mentioned this before in a video or two. You should check it out. I'll have a link in the description below that you can go check it out afterwards and watch and see the majesty of his bottle opener collection, because he's got a lot. Anyway, it's impressive to say the least. So, one thing I want to point out here. So this is the, I guess the case, whatnot, whatever you want to refer to it as. It's not really a pouch, I'd say. Wera, of course, includes these. You know, last year's, it's very similar. I'm not going to do a full comparison between the sets, but I might do a comparison between advent calendars. I've got three of them now, though. I think Wera's put out 11, so it's been a bunch. One thing I will note, I saw some people complain about this online reviews. They said these are flaps to protect it, but that's not true. I'm not calling out anybody out. I can understand the confusion. When this thing comes packed, these flaps are usually folded down, so they have a tendency to stay that way. But these are the sides of the case. And I've seen I have a couple other Wera sets. You know, obviously this was last year's advent calendar of 2019. And this is the side. So, you know, it goes like that. Just a point of information. That's about all to point out. Moving along, this is the set, obviously, itself. Let's see. So, things to note, you got two sets of sockets. I'm not really going to cover this too much. Again, just real high level. You get 13, 12, 10, 8, 7, 6, 5.5. Did find the 5.5 to be a little unusual. I don't know how useful that is in the metric world. I've never used a 5.5, but it's something to note. Of course, you get the wobble. I'm not really a fan of wobbles. I've actually broken one on another Wera set. I replaced it, but it is something to note that these things, especially the small ones, can snap. One point I will make here is that this is a twist lock set, meaning that the sockets themselves, to unlock them, you twist to the left, pull it off, and there you go. You can use it, put it back on, twist to the right, and it's locked. Very solid. A few years back, they were using the more regular, where you put it on and pull it off. I have a set, which I may do a review about sometime in the future, which has that. I prefer these a lot, honestly. I think this is an excellent thing. I don't know how well they'll last in long term, but this is last year's set, and I haven't had any trouble with it. It's got the same kind of thing. I like it a lot. It's a pretty nifty little feature, I think, for these things. I don't know that it would work for, you know, some other thing like a socket rail, because I would think for something like that, you know, maybe it's a different setup. I could be wrong on that, though, but for this type of thing, for like a pouch or kit, I think it's wonderful. They have a little graphic here. It's a patch sewn on, very nice. You can see, let me zoom in real quick here so you can see it. And you can see there's the one and the two. Like I said, pretty nice. I like this a bunch. And of course, they have it on here on these, and then they have it on the others as well. Hang on, let me focus here. Bit ratchet, or not, sorry, this is not a bit ratchet. This is actually 1/4-inch ratchet. AutobahnDan has, he actually has all the Wera ratchets, I think. He has this one too. I'll have a link in the description below to that video as well. Very impressive that he has them all. And Wera has a pretty good set. You know, they have the Cyclops, they have these, they have the Coloss. Some pretty interesting stuff. You should check it out. This one's pretty nice. It's tiny though. They have a button. It's got a spinner, which I kind of like, on the hand. And then, of course, it's got a lever, which is pretty good. And, you know, it works pretty well. I mean, it's basic stuff. It's exactly what you would expect. Pretty nice, smooth ratchet. But again, this is what you would expect from this. And they do have, if I recall correctly, they have kits where they use this as well and other things. I think AutobahnDan covered that. And like I said, check out the link description below. He talks about that a bit as well. Moving along, again, I'm kind of skipping over stuff. There's no point. Other people have covered it pretty well. And there's things that don't, you know, it's pretty basic stuff. It's what I should expect, and there's not really a point in delving into it. Now, the bit holder, I don't recall all the comments that others have made, but I do have some concerns about this. It's supposedly, you know, similar to the stubby, but it's not the same. This, and the reason why it's not the same is because it holds bits. So if you've ever had one of the other Wera sets, like the what they call the James Bond screwdrivers, like this one, you know, it pops out and whatnot, showing the bits, and then of course you close it, and then you can use it. This has. It doesn't have the same thing, and in fact, I did find this kind of, I mean, it's easy enough to pull open, and, you know, it kind of spins. I don't know how useful that is, but I will say that I'm not exactly a fan of this. I would have liked something better, and I don't say this is bad, but I have doubts about the long-term survivability of this. I mean, I see this as something that over time will wear out, or it just takes, I'm hoping they've tested this. I'm sure they have, but I just see problems with this over the long haul. Well, I would have rather had a catch or a button or unscrewing or something, maybe just a quick turn and pull, and that may have been something better. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong on that, but that's just my thoughts about this, using it. Also, the bits, I mean, you get a straight, you get a couple of Torx, a 20 and 25. You get a number 2 posi, you get a 1 and 2 Phillips. Again, this has all been covered. It's covered by other people as well. You get the magnetic bit holder. If you're going to compare it to the stubby, this standard stubby bit holder from last year's set, which you can also buy, you can see, of course, it's shorter. The handle is the standard handle, and then it's kind of big and bulbous. This also doesn't seem to fit as well in the hand as this. I like this better. Now, I have a smaller hand. Well, I kind of a medium-sized hand, not a larger hand. And I, for me, this feels a little unwieldy, I guess. But I prefer this, and it works out pretty well. You know, the bits are what they're stored here to give you an idea. Again, this is pretty basic stuff, exactly what you would expect. Pops in, got a good magnet. I will say, this is not the first time I've seen the Wera using these collars to indicate what type of bit it is. They used it on their others, where you can see here where they have the, in this case, this is a 25 and a 30 Torx. It's really nice. I like this. It's kind of handy that once you get used to their color scheme, it's pretty quick to identify, and I like the numbers. Very easy to read. So if you want to grab something really quick, well, I'd have a look at the very tiny text that's usually on these bits. This is pretty nice. I think that's a nice feature they have. And I'm not sure about the longevity of those, but I imagine it's going to last probably pretty well. I can't imagine these collars would come off or whatnot. I don't know about maybe getting grungy or anything, but, you know, I don't think they will. But I could be wrong on that. Anyway, not much else to say about that. It fits in pretty easily and whatnot. The real reason I bought this set, and I think I said this at the start, and if I didn't, I'll say it now. I actually wasn't planning on buying this, but I was curious about these 6 bits here. And actually not bits, they're kind of socket bits, I guess. So these are You have three hex bits and you have three Torx bits. I've had situations in the past where I've needed to, for whatever reason, a Torx screwdriver just isn't, it doesn't provide me with enough torque to pull off a fastener, a Torx fastener. And what I end up doing is I'll go and get a ratchet with a bed adapter and put in a Torx bit of the appropriate size, and I'll use that. But what I find is that sometimes that's a problem. And actually, let me go grab some and I will show you what I'm talking about. Back in a moment. So to give you an idea of what I'm talking about, it's something like this. So this is the Wera 1/4 inch. It's the 8004A ratchet. Pretty nice ratchet. I like it a bunch. It's pretty low profile, but got a good length. Anyway, so you end up putting the bit adapter in, and then this is just a standard Torx. This is a 20, a T20. You know, you pop it in, and there you go. And I might use this, and the leverage you can get with something like this is significant versus, say, you know, a screwdriver. I mean, and you can just get a lot more torque. But as you can tell, of course, you know, you got all this length of the adapter and whatnot. So if there's something like, say, in a tight space, and then of course there's the fussiness of having to dig all this out. Oh, I got to dig the adapter out. Oh, I got to dig the bit out, whatnot. I don't know that I can say that it's justified to go and do anything other than this, but there's a potential case for picking up these Torx bits. So, like, for example, this this is a 30. So let me grab the 20 here. So we're talking same thing. So you get like this 20 that comes in the set, the advent calendar set, you know, and then let's say I want to go and try this. Now this isn't a quite straight comparison, but already, you know, if I got a space issue, well, there's no comparison. I mean, if I've got clearance problems but still need some leverage, I can use this and do a lot better, but still have, you know, a lot of the leverage. Or to make the comparison here, I'll slide this out of the way so you can really see. You know, it's roughly almost, I guess, 2.5, but pop the adapter off and put this on, and now you're talking, you've shaved off roughly almost a little over 3/4 inch, which is pretty good. I mean, that's a pretty nice thing. So, you know, in that regard, I was real curious about these. I don't think they sell a 1/4 inch in a set. They do sell the 3/8 inch in the set. Now, one thing I will say about the Torx sets, if you've ever gone and done any digging about Torx bits and Torx sets in general, and especially in the German tools, you'll find that they are really, 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 really expensive. I mean, it's surprising how expensive the Torx stuff is. You know, compared to hex, for example, the hex bits are just cheaper by a significant margin. But like any of the Torx stuff is just, it costs a lot of money. So for me, I don't use Torx stuff that much versus, say, probably, you know, people who work in European cars. AutobahnDan is probably somebody who's got a ton of Torx stuff. That's just a guess. But I imagine that, you know, they use a lot more of that stuff. And for me, it's just not a big deal, but I was kind of curious. And of course, there's another aspect of this, is that you can also get like 3/8 inch Torx, and which is a different world. And you know, it's a question whether or not there's a justification for it, especially given the cost. Now, that isn't to say you can't find 3/8 inch sets cheap, but like even me looking for like the less expensive Taiwanese stuff, most of them have a mix of 1/4 inch and then 3/8 inch, and I don't really want that. I want either one or the other. I either want a 1/4 inch set or a 3/8 inch set. And if I want both, I'll buy both, or I'll pick up whatever I need. So, you know, and I was curious though, from the quality, hey, what is this like? Is this really worth it? Now, I will say from my standpoint, this is the same, you know, expectation what I have for any of the other sockets. In terms of quality, it's exactly what I expect from Wera. It's certainly, in terms of length, as you can tell, it's shorter. You know, the socket piece itself, because this is roughly kind of like a, I guess, a 1/4 inch bit socket, or a 1/4 inch socket, and then they put the bit in it, you know, they may press it. In some cases, I don't know that all makers do this, But some will, manufacturers will go and they'll, you can push them out and push new ones in if you break it. While in other cases, they don't let you do it and you have to buy a whole new socket. So the only thing I can say is your mileage may vary. But in that regard, you know, these are pretty nice. I like them. But, you know, these are three sizes. Honestly, if I'm going to get a set for me, what I run across is I usually run across T10 through T40. And I've actually run across T27. I always thought that was kind of an odd size, but you run across it and it you stick a 30 in thinking it's a 30, it doesn't fit. You put a 25 in, it's loose, and if it's really tight, you run the risk of damaging the fastener head. So that's kind of an issue, something to keep in mind. So there is a need for a set, but what I found, the sets that are less expensive, if they do have, say, a fixed drive of they're all 3/8 or they're all 1/4, what you end up with is they won't have the 27, or they'll go up to T60. And I'm like, oh, I don't care about T60. I want a very fixed line of stuff. So it's kind of frustrating. And again, go circle back to this. Sorry for the diversion, but I was curious about these and how well they are. And then same thing for the hex as well. Now I have a set of hex Harbor Freight ones I picked up. I don't run across these too much, but when I do, they're handy to have. Because usually you got to use an Allen wrench or something like that. Now that might be okay for one or two, but if you're doing, say, you know, your wife or girlfriend or relative or whatnot brings home an IKEA set, says, here, fix, put, help me put this together. Well, then you're either pulling out a bit, or, you know, maybe you want to use the ratchet to tighten things, or then having a hex socket bit is, I mean, it can be very handy. It can be very useful. It can save you a lot of time and a lot of effort using an Allen wrench to tighten everything, because IKEA stuff has a lot of hex stuff. Anyway, so in summary, yeah, these are pretty cool. These are also twist lock as well. No difference there. I don't know if there's really much else to say about this. Like I said, I really wasn't going to go into too much depth, and I kind of hopped off on the whole Torx thing, which is why I bought this set, honestly. I would say usefulness-wise of this set, and let me also point out that you can still find this. In fact, I think I said this earlier. If not, I'm saying it now. You can pick this up on eBay. KC Tool got them early. They sold out pretty quick. I think they got another load in, and they sold out again. You can find these variety of prices still on the internet. So if you want to get one and check it out and get a rough idea of what these are like, if you're curious about various stuff, this is, the advent calendars are a great way to do it. They're usually a good value. Sometimes the sets are really handy. Like, I think this one's pretty cool in terms of the general stuff. Now, the thing is I have a bunch of others, so it's kind of duplication for me. After all, there's only so many of these you can buy. Realistically speaking, before it begins to start just taking up and making clutter. That's for me. Other people might not. And of course, you can always give them away as gifts. You know, if you get two or three and there's enough overlap, you say, hey, I'm just going to give this away. And then you can always, I think Lone Star Mopar said this, you can always adjust it, put your own stuff in, which is certainly an option. So in any event, that's it for this video. This is pretty much all I'm going to say about the Wera 2020 Advent Calendar. First, I was kind of skeptical about it. I thought it was kind of a weak offering, but I think overall it's pretty good. Not sold on this driver. Only time will tell. And what I may do, I don't know, a few months down the road or something, do a comparison between these and kind of cover how well things have worked. I kind of like to do that. Or in some cases, I'll do a review of a tool that I've been using for a while, which I kind of prefer, because you learn things about stuff and whatnot. Like I will say, like, for example, this bit driver from last year's set, I like it a lot in terms of, you know, for a stubby, it's pretty good. It's pretty simple, pretty basic, which is what you want. And, it's, you know, fits pretty good in my hand. So at any rate, it's kind of siding off into, something else, but, that's it for this video. Hope you enjoy this. And, if you want, like, subscribe, throw in some comments. I'm curious to see what people think about these. I take that back. There's one other thing I want to talk about. Sorry. This is very important. And I did notice one flaw about this. And what I've seen, and I'm a little surprised by this, because Wera is usually pretty good about this. and their other sets have not seen this problem, but this set has a problem. So you put these sockets here, and then you're going to close this up, and if you see the issue, it hits. I do find this to be a problem, and this isn't, I don't think I'm closing this in the wrong way. If I'm going to close this, I'm going to push this down, and then boom, oh, wait. But now I kind of have a more complicated motion to close it. I have to actually leave this here, fit this in, then fold down. I find that to be a design flaw in this. And to give you a comparison, this is last year's set, and, you know, done, fold. I don't have to worry about anything. There's no concern about, you know, the order. I have to fold this just perfectly to make it fit. Versus this year's, which kind of has that problem. I find that to be it's surprising. And then, of course, the other problem is when you open it up, this thing scrapes on the inside. So I think this area here is going to get a lot of wear and tear. If you use this set a lot, if you don't, well, then don't worry about it. But it's just something to keep in mind. So anyway, didn't want to forget that point because that's one that was something in there. Anyway. Thanks for watching, and yes, it's finally over now.